Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How are you kids? I hope and pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keeps you happy and makes you the coolness of your parents' eyes. Ameen. Today, inshallah, dear kids, let's begin with the 11th juz of the Quran and look at ayah number 111 of Surah Tawbah. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, "For sure, Allah has bought from the believers their lives and their wealth, because the garden, Jannah, will be theirs. They shall fight in the way of Allah and shall slay and be slain. It is a promise which is binding on Allah in the Torah, the Gospel and the Quran. Who fulfills his covenant better than Allah? Rejoice then in your bargain that you have made, for that is the supreme triumph." Dear kids, this is one of the most beautiful verses from the Quran. In this ayah, we find out that the immense love and blessings Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the believers, bestowed them with wealth and their lives. And then in exchange for this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also gives them Jannah. Dear kids, this is an exchange which every Muslim wishes to make with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Know, children, how we too can make this amazing exchange with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The simple way to get to Jannah is that, children, we through ourselves, our wealth, our time, our skills, we try our best to gain Allah's pleasure. We do these tasks in this world, and you know what, kids? The reward will be credited to our account, and on the day of judgment, we will get Jannah, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that those Muslims who wish to get Jannah do not even hesitate to give their lives in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For them, sky is the limit. Nothing stops them from working in the way of Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that such people have been promised Jannah in the divine books like Torah, Injil and Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the most truthful. He is perfect, and no one is more capable of fulfilling promises than Allah himself. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, those Muslims who make the trade with Allah, who make the trade that for Jannah they would give up their lives, then Allah says, such Muslims should rejoice and celebrate, as there is no better trade than this. One important thing, dear kids, we need to remember is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not make this trade with every person. A person needs to have some qualities, some traits to be able to come up to the level where this trade is possible. So dear kids, let's look at these qualities. Which qualities make a person worthy of doing this trade with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Now you would ask that, why do we need to look at them? Because then we too can develop, inculcate these qualities in us, inshallah. To find out these qualities, let's look at ayah number 112 or Surah Tawbah, the translation of which is, "Triumphant are those who turn repentant to Allah, those who serve Him, those who praise Him, those who fast, those who bow down, those who fall prostrate in worship, those who enjoin the right and who forbid the wrong, and those who keep the limits ordained of Allah and give glad tidings to the believers." Dear kids, if we wish to gain Jannah, then we need to develop the qualities mentioned in the verse I just read out to you. We need to repent for all our sins, worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, say the five prayers on time, learn about the Quran and Hadith, fast during the month of Ramadan, say our voluntary prayers, give zakat. If we have the money, if we are financially capable, then perform Hajj, glorify and exalt Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make lots of dua, bow down to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a lot, do lots of sajdas, prostrations, submit to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, call others to the deen, propagate goodness, stop evil, stick, adhere to the limits set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To do this, we first need to find out what the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala are, follow them, and then tell others about them too. This way, not only we will safeguard our own iman, but strengthen the faith of others too, inshallah. Let's make a dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enables us to do so. Ameen. Dear kids, now let's look at ayah 3 of Surah Yunus and recognize who our Lord is. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, indeed, your Lord is Allah, who created the heavens and the earth in 6 days and then established himself above the throne, arranging the matter of his creation. There is no intercessor except after his permission. That is Allah, your Lord. So worship him. Then will you not remember? Dear kids, in this ayah, we find out the omnipotence, the might, the greatness, the magnificence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We find out that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the earth and the skies in just 6 days. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not just create the earth and skies and then leave them like that, but Allah established his dominion, his throne over the universe. And since time began, everything in this universe is following Allah's command and being run by him alone. Some people claim that this earth is running by itself. There is no supreme power responsible for it. But Quran tells us that it is Allah who made this earth and the skies in 6 days. And since then, each and everything in and on this earth follows a master plan and works to perfection. All under Allah's rule and by Allah's will. All governance, all power, and all control lies in the hands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone. Nothing, no atom moves in this earth but with Allah's will. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no help and needs no help in running this earth. He is alone managing all matters perfectly and is free of all human needs. No one ever even has the permission to intercede without Allah's permission, without Allah's will. What we can do is to submit to Allah's will, know and trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves us, and we should pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, make lots of dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so he subhanahu wa ta'ala grants us the best of both the worlds. Ameen. Moving on, let's look at Surah Yunus, ayah number 5. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, it is Allah who made the sun a shining light and the moon a derived light and determined for it phases, that you may know the number of years and account of time. Allah has not created this except in truth. He details the signs for a people who know. Dear kids, we can see that in this verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling those people who disbelieve in the day of judgment, giving them evidence that day of judgment will get established. People will be resurrected. They will come back to life. They will be recompensed. Accountability will be taken and people will be sent to Jannah or hell. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, in the movement of the sun and the moon, in the changing of the day and night, Allah has given the blessing of time to people. We are able to give some amount of measure to how we spend our while. We have been able to formulate time into days, into months. If we reflect on all these movements and transitions, they compel us to think about a supreme power, an omnipotent deity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created all these things for our reflection, not for the sake of enjoyment only. These things are created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as a sign of his existence and power. They have been created as a test, so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can see who will believe and who will disbelieve. Dear kids, we find out about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran and Hadith. If we wish Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to save us and our families from the scary pits of hellfire, then we should learn about the Quran and Sunnah. Act upon it too, inshallah. Let's end today's talk with a prayer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enables us to lead our lives according to the Quran and Sunnah. Ameen. Till next time, children, look after yourselves. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu.